This video demonstrates the process by which a facility administrator would review access requests submitted by other staff at their BloodSTAR facility. If you have more than one BloodSTAR role or access to more than one facility, you'll need to choose from the Select Role Facility menu. This can be accessed at any time using the Change Role link at the top of the screen. I will be actioning access requests for the fictional Princeton Teaching Hospital, so I will select this role. I can see that there are currently 6 requests pending approval. I will have received email notification of the pending requests at the time they were submitted by staff at my facility. I can action these by clicking on User Access Requests. For a medical officer, nurse, or midwife to successfully submit an access request so that it is visible for me in this screen, they must choose my facility, provide a valid APRA registration number, and accept the system terms and conditions. To action the request, I simply need to verify 3 additional things. The personal details of the APRA registration match the personal details submitted by the user, that the user holds an appropriate registration for the role that has been requested, and that the user is employed by or practices at my facility. The requirements for verifying that a staff member holds an appropriate position may vary, as this is to be determined at a local facility level. For a smaller facility, the facility administrator may know the staff member requesting access. For a larger facility, this may need to be checked against an administrative record or by checking with a supervising staff member. Again, I can confirm that the name matches. There is a medical APRA registration number for a medical officer role, and I know this doctor, so I can verify that they hold an appropriate position at my facility. In this case, the name and registration matches the role, but I don't know this doctor. After checking with someone in administration, I have verified that this doctor is not employed by or practicing at my facility. I will reject this request and give a reason. I can repeat this checking process for the remaining access requests. This request has come back with a status of name check required, as the names do not match. The first name Sher does not match Charisse on the APRA registration. I have checked with the nurse unit manager and this is the same person. I can approve this request. A facility administrator may also have a clinical role at their facility. If this is the case, they are able to approve their own access request. All users will be notified by email and in the system that their request has been actioned. It is recommended that facility administrators keep their contact details up to date in the system and check regularly for user access requests. This is of particular importance in the lead up to BloodSTAR Go Live and also during periods of staff rotation at your facility.